Hello, everybody, and welcome to our third annual holiday playthrough to wrap up the entire year of 2023. This is TJ, and yep, as you can see on the screen, we are doing RoboCop Rogue City. And I chose this game not too long ago, once I concluded Alan Wake 2, which was probably the best playthrough I've done this entire year. Now, RoboCop Rogue City, as you know, takes place, or as you may not know, depending on if you play this game or not, this game takes place between RoboCop 2 and RoboCop 3. Yeah, that dreaded RoboCop 3 that Robert John Burke took over, and a lot of stuff happened in that movie, which shouldn't have happened, to say the least. So, let's see what this is all about. Oh, there's the main menu. I like the piano theme here. Let's go on the options here for a moment, but let's see here. Reduce footsteps volume. Okay. Streamer mode, what's that? I'll look at that later on. Quality, let's do performance. The quality? No, performance. We'll do performance. Motion blur on, chromatic aberration, leave that alone. So I had this game locked up for quite a while I was playing Alan Wake 2. This game came out not too long ago in early November. And so, look at the controls here. And so, I'm really interested to see how this game turns out, because for the property that's at hand that was produced by Nacon, it's got some really good reviews, some really decent reviews, and so I want to see how this game turns out. I've seen how violent this game is, so it should be just as violent as the first two movies, or at least the first movie, I should say. And I was on a RoboCop movie binge. I was playing. I was watching mainly RoboCop 1 and 2, and you guys already know RoboCop 1 is an instant classic. And normal, let's do normal. And so I'm really excited to see how Peter Weller does his role in this whole game. I think this is like his fourth or fifth time he's returned to the role. He did something before. Oh, he did some vocal acting for either the Mortal Kombat 10 or Mortal Kombat 11. Oh, I haven't played those games, but I've seen how he was one of the DLC characters in the Mortal Kombat games. And so we're gonna see. The one thing I'm really, really concerned about, as you guys know, how RoboCop 2 ended was when he killed Kane, and then somewhere behind the scenes, the old man somehow switched teams, but he got really corporate greedy about how he wanted to take over Detroit with his military and all that stuff. And so I want to see what happened prior to the events of part 3, and I think this game may explain what happened, because I read that the character the old man is in this game, as well as Alex Murphy and Lewis as well too, I'm hoping the Desk Sergeant Reed is in this game as well too. So we're gonna take a look at this game, see how this turns out, but we should be in for a really fun one throughout the month of December. So I'm really excited to conclude 2023 with this game right here. So let's get this game started. Is that the OCP logo on the loading? Well, it starts off just like the first game too, with a news flash, or a news report, I should say. I like this.
You give us 3 minutes, and we give you the world.
Good evening. Casey Wong.
A military submarine that went missing over 3 years ago has suddenly reappeared in the Baltic Sea. Confused seamen mistakenly opened fire on the last Lapland reservation, killing 12. Thankfully, our homesick sailors are back on U.S. soil. Welcome back, boys. In local news, a new crime wave that is sweeping Detroit has already claimed the lives of 21 police officers. Here's a statement from the head of OCP, omni-consumer products that's funding and running the Detroit Police Department.
Old Detroit has a cancer, and that cancer is crime. It must be cut out, and OCP holds the scalpel.
According to our sources, the attacks were aimed at catching the attention of a man whose identity remains unknown. This dangerous new guy in town seems to have his eye on doing business in Old Detroit.
Your filthy hands off me! Shut
I'm sorry. There seems to be a...
What's going on? Oh! Who's this?
Disturbance?
Look at that hair. Like a double mohawk.
Now move!
Oh, by the way, the old man, I didn't like his voice,
don't
whoever's voice acting him.
Your regularly scheduled program will be back shortly.
Almost looks like Heihachi.
Goes out to the new
Ace Ventura.
It seems that you're looking to spend some money in this great city of ours. I'm here to tell you that the Torchheads are open for business. You may have heard of us as the number one supplier of nuke in Old Detroit. The most potent, addictive drug available in front of every convenience store, school, or library near you. But that's not all we're capable of.
That nuke.
Let's get you up here. We'll get Officer Howard to illustrate the point. You see, Officer Howard made a drug bust that cost us a lot of money. We want to reward this dutiful officer with a performance bonus. A lifetime supply of nuke. Oh, man, you're gonna have the time of your life. There you go. Enjoy. New guy. Us Torchheads are more than capable of doing whatever you need done in our city. So what is it, huh? Arson, smuggling, drug dealing, good old-fashioned murder. We do it all. You've got the money. We've got the power. So let's talk.
But yeah, I want to go back to the old man. Whoever's voice acting him did not do him justice, because he does not sound anything like that from the first two movies. He sounded a little more grim and gruff. But that one sounded a little too happy, I should say, for an old man. Oh, there you go. There's Alex Murphy. Nice.
See you, Murphy. Lieutenant's at the main entrance to the TV station.
Oh, I can see it. When I hold the left trigger, I can see the screen change a bit. I like that.
The ground's shaking. Judgment Day is here!
So I press the left D-pad and this comes up. Oh, this is nice. Some RPG elements. Okay, I got this. The Autumn Rain. I can't wait to see how that gun plays out. A little kitty cat. Wait, is that supposed to be a shadow of some sort? Yeah, I think I'm gonna like this game.
This town is going to hell.
Like we're not there already.
They came out of the
getting shaken up.
So far, it's not quite open world, but it looks pretty good. This looks like San Francisco. I'll tell you, the RoboCop films, especially the first one, was way ahead of its time. Like it, I hate to say it, but the way they depicted Detroit is pretty much the way they're depicting some of the more populous cities like definitely San Francisco, for instance. I love my city, but geez, yeah, New York is like that as well too. So pretty much any big urbanized city will depicted the way the game is depicting Detroit here. Fuck, was that a body? Holy shit.
We can't wait any longer. Those trigger-happy maniacs have a ton of hostages. But sir, Roger that. Over and out.
What is the situation?
Goddamn OCP tells us to stand down till SWAT arrives. That's our situation.
Looks like I'm on the way out.
Not so fast, buddy. Who do you think is gonna clean up this place? I'm not letting you off that easily.
You sound just like my wife.
If that's the case, let's get you patched up. We wouldn't want to get on her bad side. Press here. Medic! There you are, partner.
Lewis.
The hell is going on up there?
Now, I don't think that's Nancy Allen, but she definitely
sounds close
to the actual character.
Want us to release the hostages. So no hard feelings.
God damn, another body.
Hey, you can't go in yet. We need to wait for the reinforcements.
Reinforcements have arrived.
I knew you'd say something like that.
We need to find another way. It is too dangerous to cross.
For me. But you can take the heat. Go. I'll figure something out. Besides, you could do with a head start. Go on.
I feel a little mixed about the way he moves. Hold on, more on that.
Guys, we've got company. Anyone expecting a silver freak?
Drop it, scum.
Torchhead will burn you alive!
That's pretty cool. They got Basil Paul Doris's theme in here. I like that. Crime evidence, okay, give me some extra points for that. This sounds like a mighty version of the soundtrack, but I'll still give them credit for bringing the soundtrack back. Oh crap, a bunch of them. I don't miss anything here.
All personnel, evacuate.
Worried about the weight limit?
Lewis, you're here.
We need to get these elevators back online. The service box is in the basement.
Let me.
I doubt you had time between all the heroics, but I got a key card from the janitor. It's good to do some real street work from time to time, you know? After you.
Save you some damage on that.
They sabotage the elevators and staircase too. They obviously don't want to be disturbed.
Check to make sure I don't miss anything here. Stole a wallet.
That graffiti is fresh.
I bet some of those idiots are still here.
Nuke.
I will keep.
What a warm welcome, don't you think?
Did this head just explode? He lost his arm, poor guy. I like this game. This is pretty cool. This is definitely living up to the RoboCop moniker here. God, Lord. save that other one for later on.
You're gonna die here! Back up, or I'll kill you!
That's really sick. Alright, let me slam you to the wall. I like this. This is so simple and fun. Well, let me heal myself. Get that other OCP charge. Here. This is cool. More crime evidence here. Let's see what we got here. Poor guy. Just had some pizza the other day. Basic. Pretty good. Although the flatbread pizza is actually not that bad. I actually like that. No, excuse me. Move out of the way. You definitely don't want to get punched. You don't want to get punched by RoboCop at all. Lose more than your head. How stupid do you have to be to throw a grenade that close?
Why don't you check it out?
You guys are really hooked up on nuke. See what we got here. Where?
I am detecting a short circuit. We need to isolate the cables.
I think I've got something just for that.
You are very resourceful.
Thanks, but I'd say it was a team effort. They're holding everyone in the studio. It's on the 30th floor.
I like how they keep the old style tele.
Show. I'm afraid you're too late for my autograph.
Chopper's ready.
I've gotta go. But the party goes on. Guys, make sure you provide all our guests with a decent amount of amusement, so don't skimp on the nuke. See ya.
What a freaking psycho. We need to be quick.
Did you see that?
Before you kill anyone else. I know that look, Murphy. You saw something, didn't you?
Saw his old face. I just noticed that.
The law, Lewis. Let us stay focused.
Right. Just keep in mind that I'm here if you need me, partner.
Slime bags detected.
Just look at that, boys! The police dog and its bitch!
Not sure which one is which.
You're gonna take that back.
Cribbing pictures of what? Politicians? Let's grab him with the monitor. Oh, hold on a second. Let me try this out. Let's see how high I am. Oh wow, I'm really high up there. Okay. Half his head's gone. This Auto-9's really nasty. Pull up his own dude. That's funny. case full of nuke. Whoops, didn't press that. Oh, did she die?
Thank God you've come. This lady really needs to see a doctor.
Murphy, these people need help. Why don't you go ahead? I'll stay with them.
Right.
This is Lewis. We have rescued three hostages, one with a gunshot wound to the abdomen, requesting urgent medical assistance. Over.
After the team just flew up in chunks. Good lord.
Thank you.
Alright, I gotta be really careful how I handle the freaking kerosene or whatever gas tank this is. That's horrible. Holy crap. I mean that in a good way. Shit off his legs. I like that. Just like in the drug scene, the drug factory scene, the guys fell off. Let me see this right here. Area here, that's part of the studio.
Sure thing, Mom. What are we having?
surprise. Little man, have you washed your hands? Do I really have to? I wasn't playing in the dirt. Of course you do. No more discussion. Darn. What about Dad? Is he gonna be back for dinner?
Sad.
Alex, what do you think about the color of this dress? I'm not sure if I like the pattern. James really looks up to you. He said in school that he wants to be a police officer just like his dad.
Looks like everybody's safe. Oh, there's one.
Hey! No sudden moves, cop! I'm not dying here! Get me another one of those choppers, like the one that took Soot! You hear me?
You worked so hard, honey. Why don't you take some leave? We all could use a little break from this reality, don't you think?
Wakey wakey! I'm talking to you, Shiny! Stand back from that door, or I'll shoot her! I swear to Nuke!
I don't know what I would do if I ever lost you.
You've got 3 seconds! 3!
Our family is the only thing I need to be happy.
2! Are you fucking deaf?
Trust me, we will stay like this forever.
1! Last chance, weirdo!
I love you so much, Alex. You okay there, Murphy?
What does it want? Get it away from me!
I am sorry.
Can you see? It's unstable!
Ma'am, please, calm down. It's been a very tough evening, and I assure you that everyone wants to be back home with their families. Though for some of us, the night has just begun.
Damn, that's the title after all that? It's the same look of that police station. I like that. Oh, there's Death Sergeant Reed right there. Nice. Animation.
Cash?
God.
No problem. Do you take singles?
Get back in line.
They're here. Good job, Murphy.
I think you're forgetting someone.
Officer Lewis, you were remarkable.
Soot ran off with his tail between his legs.
Would have been nice if we caught him, though.
All right. Are you done with this circle jerk, huh? Good. We've got a problem.
The malfunction caught on camera provokes a question. Can we put our safety into the hands of a machine? Especially one as unreliable as RoboCop. We asked Max Becker, the head of security concepts at OCP.
Now quiet!
We would never put a defective product on the streets. That's not what we do.
We all saw it hesitate in a life and death situation. Why? Does it really know right from wrong?
Listen, I would trust this guy with my kids. I mean, if I had any. This was just an isolated glitch. Thank you.
Mr. Becker, I've got more questions.
I just want to snap her little neck. But she's got a point. This was not an isolated incident. It's a pattern. A pattern that the old man wants examined and fixed. Time to see what's hiding in that metal head of yours.
We know what's in Murphy's head. It's what's in yours that worries us.
Push me, and you might just find out. You, follow me.
Everyone is dismissed. And Lewis, I need your report on the TV station incident. On the double.
On it, Sarge.
Let me look around the police station first, see if there's anything special around here. What's this? This situation. What's this? Nancy McGuire? Oh, reporting. Holy crap. See here, hold on, let me see how I can guide myself objective. Oh, there we go. So that's a secondary. Okay, let's do this one. Get the experience points, that's kind of whack. We'll get us some points though. Alright, let's do the side quest first, and then we'll call it an episode. I want to slow myself a bit. I got myself caught up pretty well excited in this, the first 40 plus minutes of playing this game. I'll talk with Estevez after I search around a bit more. This is literally scale for scale, the same way the police station, like, I like how they constructed the police station over here from the movies. That's impressive. I like this. Look around and see if there's anything else special. Can I repair my freaking my windshield off this? Or my eye shield, I should say. Yeah, there's the ramp that you drive up. Yeah, that's definitely the ramp. Looks a little, not as steep as the movies, but still a good, that's still a good replication of how the movie displayed it. What's this? Alright, let me go upstairs.
Hi, Murphy.
Oh, yeah.
Hi.
That's the same guy from the first movie, too. That's pretty good. I like that. Where is the data? Where's the... I'm trying to see. Was it this one? Yeah, this is it right here. That's the data spike right there. Okay. Oh, nice. Test myself over here. Let me play with this real quick. This is gonna come by faster shit. Damn it. That's still good though. 165. Oh, I got an achievement for that. Score 150 points at the shooting range. Nice. Okay, take that. This room seems shorter than the one in the movie though. I think this was much longer. Those like what, 20 officers in the shooting range in the movie when they saw Murphy testing out that auto mine. Alright, cool. Alright, we can go with this area. Let's keep going. I'm holding cell. Okay.
Robo Pig! Why do you have to spoil our fun all the time? You metal freak!
When will this be fixed?
Don't hold your breath. OCP isn't looking to spend a dime on our equipment.
The hell is this, another side mission? Let me tell them real quick. This weakling.
What seems
maybe
something
stuck in there.
The problem.
My damn locker won't open. Can you try? Wait, what is all this shit doing in my locker?
I wanted you to be safe out there.
Seriously?
Yeah, you
not
guys,
funny.
Very fun.
Let me help out Estevez real quick.
I can deal with blood, guts, but puke is a no-go for me. Oh, be a sport and move his ass to the drunk tank for me. You've got your special gloves and extra protection, so you shouldn't mind.
All right. Let me pick
just
you up.
Downstairs. I owe you one, Murphy. Oh no, the smell is following you. I'm gonna be sick.
Chi-Town? Excellent management and access to the latest technology. Will this convince more authorities to put their law enforcement forces in private hands? More on page 6. Well, now it's 5 points away from leveling up. Good. There we go. Still
this
there.
Speed is uncomfortable.
who's back home. Just toss him in one of the empty cells.
Finally. Home.
Sleep tight.
Sleep tight. Some impressive stats here. Should I upgrade? I need some experience points. Alright, where was I at? This floor? Oh, I passed it right here. Okay, here we go. They still use hard disks. Man, I like how they kept everything
my favorite walking, talking,
like it was 1990 in the game or in the
okay,
movie.
Let's get on
takes place in the future. What was that? Oh, never mind. There we go. I gotta look and see if the cameras are up there next time I enter these areas. Wasn't Lewis in that room? Not anybody else on that screen? Another note. Let's see what this is. RoboCop program. Ooh. Rest in peace. Ascending. We'll pick once more, then I'll head back to the main objective. Oh, so the camera is right up there. That's a good detail. Okay. And up there too, on the left, right there. Okay. Alright, let's fix my eye shield on my helmet.
Why don't you take a seat for me? That's a nasty scar. I'd like to see the other guy. Am I right?
You do not. Trust me.
Don't mind me. I'll just get this off.
So, here's the deal, Robo. The old man is not happy with your performance. Instead of sending you to the scrapyard, as I suggested, he wants to fix you. Hey, pretty boy. You sure know how to make an impression on the ladies.
She should have known.
Doesn't it hurt him?
Hurt? Lady, he's a machine. He's legally dead. We can do whatever we want with him.
No, madam. It does not hurt me physically.
So we're going to equip you with a little monitoring chip. It will do a real-time check of your systems so we can get to the bottom of what the hell is wrong with you. From now on, your performance will be monitored and graded. So better be on your best behavior, huh?
The chip is in. Let's see what we have here.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Stevie's secret.
I missed one, though. Yeah, one of them died. TV station secret number one found. What did I find? What was secret? Did I get a notification or something? Hey! Alright, good. Officer of the month. Score A on any evaluation. Alright. So I got, 3 points, even better. Alright, so let's see what I can upgrade.
I can already see some unwanted activity in your hippocampus.
Well, nice, I'll have to keep an eye on it.
Other than that, everything seems to be installed correctly. To be sure, let's make a simple test to check that all circuits are in order. What are your prime directives?
Serve the public trust. Protect the innocent.
Uphold the law.
Okay, nothing disturbed. However, like with any new upgrade, I recommend visiting the range to check if you need calibration.
Is that everything?
Actually, no. Doctor?
Oh, yes, sorry. My name is Dr. Olivia Blanche. I'm a police psychologist. I specialize in dealing with police officers suffering from emotional trauma.
Emotional trauma? Might as well talk to the microwave. It hasn't been working properly either.
OCP wanted to see if you'd be willing to have a talk with me as part of your evaluation. I noticed that a great deal of care has been put into making sure that your mechanical components work. However, one aspect of your composition that has been severely neglected is your human side, your brain.
I agree. If it was up to me, I'd remove it altogether. What do you think, Doctor? Would save us a lot of hassle.
I don't mind the hassle. So what do you say, officer? Is that possibly something that could be of interest to you?
I am not sure.
Robo, Reed wants everyone in the briefing room in 5. It's about the new guy.
Excuse me, Dr. Blanche, but I am needed elsewhere.
But we...
Well, can't say we didn't try. Everyone get back to whatever the fuck you usually do around here.
You are so mean. Yeah, even the room where RoboCop rests up and recovers, that's also spot for spot. Shot for shot,
man,
as well,
I
too.
Tell you, it was crazy in that TV station. Good job you had Murphy in with you. You bet. Without him, we'd all be goners.
And this guy still here smoking without a shirt on. Funny. Alright, let's see. I'm going in circles. Alright, let's go to the briefing room. I think it's one floor down.
Murphy,
I saw it.
Could you please help me out here?
Out. Hey, where's Reed? Is he on break?
What seems to be the problem, officer?
Reed is in the briefing room, and I have my hands full. There are so many complaints filing in that I can't keep up. It's getting crazy in here. Could you open up another line and help me?
I am here to serve the public trust.
Take the spot on the podium. You're a lifesaver, Robo.
Alright, here I go. Let's help him out.
This line is open. Please form an orderly queue.
Officer, I have a problem. My neighbors are hostile toward me. I think it's because they're jealous of my new dog. Why would they get so worked up every time I take him for a walk?
What is his name?
He has a beautiful red coat, so I call him Fire. He likes to hide, so sometimes I have to yell, Fire! Fire to find him. Anyway, can you do something about my neighbors?
No. But I will let you off with a warning.
That's fine. I don't mind paying the price for having the cutest dog in all of Detroit.
Next, please.
I know where you can find a wanted criminal. That poster over there says there's a reward for that information. And I want it.
I want details.
Are you blind? I'm the guy from that poster, so... Here I am. Now, give me the money.
I will have to detain you.
Fine, but
sure.
I still get the reward, right?
No. I don't know. I want to say this one, but I feel like that's going to backfire. You can hope for a reduced sentence. No, you do not. Let's do that. Reduced sentence.
Hope for a reduced sentence.
It's not the reward I was hoping for, but I'll take it. It'd be good to get back to jail. Life as a free man can be tiring.
Take him away. Next, please.
Officer, I would like to report my son missing.
How old is he?
He's 24, but he's never been gone for so long without letting me know.
How long has it been?
Just over 2 days now.
We do not consider an adult missing within 72 hours.
Oh, please, I'm begging you. Something's not right. You really need to find him.
What is his name and address?
George Elkins, 7706 Orchard Avenue.
Let me check. Your son was found dead 2 hours ago.
That's sad.
Oh, no.
Thanks for the help, Murphy.
Yeah, but that's not the ending I wanted. God, that's horrible. Man, this is this game's gonna be even tougher than I expected it to be. Not from a gameplay standpoint, but like, you know, the emotional repercussions of such. Well, I'm not gonna get too emotional over those things. I mean, that's the real world right there. But geez, for them to implement that in this game.
Murphy, I heard your schedule calibration. Step right up and press the button when you're ready. Points is what OCP calls a passing grade. Shouldn't be a problem to you.
I'll do this again.
Unless you want to try to break the record.
I'll let the eggheads know that you're good to
damn,
go.
Damn, that sucks. I can do that one.
So, what's on today's agenda?
The agenda is that you sit your ass down and listen.
No, I have not had time.
Y'all better be nice.
It's no secret that crime has been on the rise ever since what the media has named the new guy in town showed up in the city. The word on the street is that he wants to spend a lot of money in old Detroit, and that has made every gang in the city start advertising their services. We need to find him before things get out of control.
Where do we look?
Our best bet is to see if he made contact with the Torchheads. Robo, I want you to start by checking the arcade downtown. It's become a high activity area for punks.
Understood.
Everyone else, keep your eyes open. Any questions?
Any word on Briggs?
What happened to Briggs?
He's been missing since yesterday.
Shit.
Officer Briggs remains missing. That's over 24 hours since he's been in contact with anyone here.
Are the two cases connected?
No reason to assume so. But if anyone finds Briggs' informant, we might learn something new. All right, now get out there.
You go ahead, partner. I need to write this report. And there's something else I need to do first.
Alright, so let me see where this leads to. Leave the precinct. Okay.
Cruiser's ready for you, Robo. Go get him.
Thank you. adjust the camera on this. Am I tripping? Where's the camera? Yeah, you know, whatever. I'll find it later on. Alright, so let's head out to wherever we gotta go. Yes, we'll leave the area. Oh yeah, let me see if the tail of the car hits the... It does! Okay, that's even better. Alright, good. Alright, let's see where the story heads into, and then we're gonna wrap up this episode. Hell.
City, didn't you? It'd be easier to burn it all to the ground. Believe me, just burn it all.
Alright, so we're gonna end the episode over here. This is a great start to our holiday playthrough. I'm liking how everything is not just replicated, but I think it's just... It's translated... This game... they pretty much translated everything well from what I've seen in the first couple of from pretty much the entire trilogy, I should say. Well, mainly the first two films, I should say, because they were both rated R. But the next episode, we're gonna see if we could talk to anybody down in downtown over here, if they could find out where Suit is at, and see if we can counter any more side quests that can help us upgrade our abilities and then some. Alright guys, thanks for tuning in. I will see you to episode 2 on our holiday playthrough of RoboCop Rogue City. Take care, guys.